All right, this is one of the most high-quality budget laptops you can buy, the Surface Laptop Go. Is it worth it? We've got 7 items to cover, so let's go over the raw stats. The Surface Laptop Go is Microsoft's cheapest default skin laptop, starting at $550. But default is actually kind of an insult considering what this laptop comes with, starting with externals. The Surface Laptop Go has a 12.4-inch touchscreen with an okay resolution, but a great weight. This is the lightest Surface Laptop, which you probably will care about if you travel a lot, such as if you're a student. And even with that small size, it's still able to have an okay port selection. One USB-A, one USB-C, a headphone jack, and the Surface Connect port. But I wouldn't mind an extra USB port or two to kind of round things out. And speaking of things I don't mind, the processor. It's not amazing, but it surely can help you get your work done and even play some light games. But no GTA 5. Here are the benchmarks. And speaking of light, for storage, this laptop is just as bad as the Surface Go 3. 64 gigabytes, literally less than many people's phones. But if you want more, you can buy an external SSD. But what you can't buy more of is an extra battery, so thank God, this one is good. Most reviewers have praised the laptop for having an extraordinary battery performance, but a few have claimed it to be subpar. Therefore, I'm gonna go with the median on this one and say 10 hours, which is still amazing, especially for a laptop this size. And lastly, this laptop runs Windows 11. And now before we get on to my verdict, hear what the reviewers said about this laptop. The Surface Laptop Go was praised for its build quality, battery life, and affordability. And it was criticized for its mediocre GPU, display resolution, and lack of keyboard backlighting. So, what's the situation with this laptop? Why consider buying this one over the others? If you didn't already know, there are many about $500 laptops that you can purchase from HP, Acer, and Dell, such as this one. It looks like it has some pretty good specs, right? More RAM, more ports, bigger display. Why even consider the Surface Laptop Go if you can buy this instead? Good question. Two things. First, when buying a piece of technology, it might be wise to kind of know and research the company that you'll be supporting, which will eventually be supporting you. More specifically, Dell is known for providing an okay customer service experience, while Microsoft has a pretty good track record. And second, the Dell laptop does beat the Surface Laptop Go in some categories, but the Go beats the Dell in performance. Check out these benchmarks. Right, so things aren't as black and white as they might appear. Even still, although it may seem like it from time to time, I am not a Microsoft fanboy. So the decision on which laptop you should buy is ultimately yours, but I'm just trying to make sure that you go through the thorough research so you don't get stuck with something problematic. But ultimately, all of this is your decision based on your preferences. Don't just watch my video on this. I've linked many more down in the description to view at your discretion. My name is Seeroos. It's spelled like Cyrus, pronounced like Seerooster. Just take out the tur. Thank you very much for watching. Good luck with your purchase and have a wonderful day.